Hello dear students, you are welcome in this video. Dear students, this is a high time of examinations and we find that many universities and institutions have organized exams for students, and students need to appear for those exams. As we saw that Supreme Court has given the decision to conduct examinations. So dear students, we got very good response to our videos and hence on demand I am making this type of videos. Actually we got a tremendous response for this video called "What is feminism and a few concepts of feminism." In the same line I am making one more video on feminism. Basically this video is dedicated to one of the prominent and dominant contemporary feminist theorist, Ellen Showalter. So we will explore Ellen Showalter and her contribution to the feminist critical theory. So dear students, here let's understand Ellen Showalter and her contribution through some points. Dear students, here you can see Ellen Showalter and her contribution to feminism. Let me clear one point here before starting. It is not possible to cover whole contribution of Ellen Showalter and Ellen Showalter herself as a feminist literary theorist, because her contribution to literary theory is tremendous. She is one of the dominant and prominent voice in contemporary feminist theory. So I will try to focus major points. I will try to make this video based on the primary contribution of Ellen Showalter, or some important contribution of Ellen Showalter. So let's start. Here first we will talk about short intro of Ellen Showalter, then we will cover most important works as feminist writer, then we will cover division of women's writing, and last point there would be four models of difference. So let's start with the very first point. So here you can see on the screen Ellen Showalter. She was born in America in 1941 and she studied at Brian Moore College and University of California. Then she worked as a teacher and taught at various institutions, including some prestigious institutions like Rutgers University and Princeton University. And dear students, she retired in 2003. Now I will show you her current profile. I actually checked the website of Princeton University and there I found her profile, what nowadays she doing and how she is breaking her time in various activities. So let me show you the same thing. So dear students, here you can see Ellen Showalter's profile on englishprinceton.edu website. This website is of the Princeton University website, and here you can see Department of English at Princeton. This is the official website of Princeton University, and here we have some description of Ellen Showalter stating what she is currently doing. Since retiring in 2003, Ellen Showalter has been dividing her time between Washington DC and London, where she was recently elected a fellow of Royal Society of Literature in 2012. She also received an honorary degree from the University of St. Andrews in Scotland and won the Truman Capote Award for Literary Criticism for a jury of her peers, American women writers from Anne Bradstreet to Annie Proulx. She also attended her 50th class reunion at Brown Moyer and spoke at the Colony Club in New York with Joyce Carol Oates. Ellen is currently working on a biography of Julia Ward Howe to be published by Simon and Schuster. So dear students, this is the current profile of Ellen Showalter. You can see that how she is engaged herself in different activities. Actually she has been awarded many awards and she also received some prizes. Everything we can find in her profile, and she retired in 2003. This is the basic information of Ellen Showalter. If you want more information, just you can go to Google and search, you will get all the information. But I think this is enough for this kind of literary theory which we are talking here. So dear students, next we have her most important works related to feminist theory or related to feminism. Here we have very first, actually it is book A Literature of Their Own, women writers from Bronte to Lessing, published in 1977. Then we have her two essays, Towards a Feminist Poetics. It is actually a lecture delivered in 1978, but later it is published as an essay. And then we have third essay, Feminist Criticism in the Wilderness, published in 1981. Actually, it is published in the prestigious journal called Critical Inquiry. And the above essay number two, Towards a Feminist Poetics, published in an anthology of edited essays. So, dear students, I have selected only three pieces of works because these three works are groundbreaking in feminist literary theory. If you think about the very first book, we find that it is a groundbreaking work in the field of feminist literary theory, because here in this work she directly gives us the historical avenue of literary theory, basically feminism, very specially feminism. She is talking about right from Charlotte Bronte to Doris Lessing, and she has given a historical base of all British women writers. If you look at here, I have included a cover also of the same book. You can see here Ellen Showalter's a literature of their own British women writers. It is called as From Charlotte Bronte to Doris Lessing. So these three works are very important in the field of feminist literary theory. Dear students, now we have her major contribution to literary theory or feminism. It is division of women's writing. She divides women's writing in three phases. Actually, these three phases are well known in feminism. Very first phase is feminine phase, which ranges from 1840 to 1880. Second, we have feminist phase, 1880 to 1920. And third, we have female phase, 1920 onwards. Actually, we have made a dedicated video on what is feminism. You also can check that video and understand the very primary base of feminism, what is feminism, and different types of contributors to the feminism. Here, especially, we are talking about Ellen Showalter and her contribution. So, dear students, you can check it. I will provide you the link in description. Please watch that video also and understand feminism in detail with this video. And again, next contribution, we have a few terms. She has coined actually a term called gynotexts. Now, what is gynotexts? Gynotext is texts written by women. Very simply, she states. We have androtexts. In the same line, we have again two terms, androtexts and gynocritics. What is androtexts? Androtexts are nothing but the texts written by men. And gynocritics is nothing but the study of gynotexts or gynocriticism. So there is a very large field emerged in feminism, that is gynocriticism. If you look at that gynocriticism, it is nothing but the study of gynotexts. And the gynotext, this concept is coined by Ellen Showalter. Gynotexts are the text written by women writers. So she talks about women writers in two ways. She says that women writers are different and women as an audience or women as a reader is different. So this difference we are going to explore in the next points. So these three terms you need to understand very carefully: gynotexts, androtexts, and gynocritics. This is the contribution of Ellen Showalter. Now, dear students, here we have her major contribution. She has developed four models of difference between men and women, and based on this difference we have four models. She talks about biological, psychological, linguistic, and the cultural model of this feminist theory or the feminine writing. So we will explore all these things. So very first we have biological. Now, in this model, if you look at this screen, you will find a few points. So, biological difference is the basic difference between men and women, according to Ellen Showalter. You find that this difference has created a narrative in literature or in history, she is stating here. So, this difference is considered an inferiority, and it is on both levels, physical and mental level. And generally, we find that there is a point of view regarding women, or we find there is a common view regarding women, that women are not so strong. They need protection. They also need patronage. These kind of narratives we have in history and literature. And here she breaks these narratives. Those points which are considered as the points lacking in women, she thinks that they are strong points for women. And in the next green points, you see that there is female body as a resource. So this is the basic thing Ellen Showalter talks about. So female body is not inferiority, or female body cannot lack in anything, but it is a resource of creative kind of things, creative kind of urge. So it is against or opposite to men, which men generally traditionally think about women, that they are inferior, they need patronage, they need protection, they need many things from men. But this kind of thought has been broken by Ellen Showalter here by giving a straightforward answer, that female body is a resource of creativity. And she next says that it is a special asset denied to men. What men received is for men, but what women received, it is denied for men. So women have special qualities. Now she is making strong points out of the weak points of women. So she is saying that men are not given a particular qualities which women are bestowed with. So these qualities are great for women, and this is the basic difference. And she talks this in the biological model of this feminist theory. And based on this, further she says that women thinks differently based on their different abilities. Different kinds of qualities have been bestowed upon women, and so that they have different experiences, they have different thoughts, they have different kind of mental setup than men. And this difference is their strong points. This difference is particularly the major point for women. It is a resource of creativity. So this is the point she covers in this biological model of feminist theory. Number two, we have women's writing and language. The next important thing or the next model, we have language. So whether men and women use language differently, this is the very first question she poses. And the very straight answer she gives, that yes, there is a difference between the language of men and the language of women. So what kind of difference is that? Let's see that. She says oppressor's language or sexist language. So men basically use this language, this kind of language, oppressor's language. So the language of men is different than the language of women. And most of the times men uses oppressor's language or sexist language. The portrayal of women, if you find in traditional literature, the picture of women which is created there in the literature is through the language of men, is through the perspective of men, is through the point of view of men, and hence she rejects that view. Men's language is a foreign language. According to many feminist critics, actually it is not by Ellen Showalter only, but there are other critics who also think that men's language is a foreign language for women. And based on that language, women cannot create their own identity. So they need to create their own language. And next we find that there is a need of women's language, and this need can be fulfilled by creating a different style. So many feminist critics lays emphasis on creating the own style of women writers. So they give importance to creating a new language, a different language than men, different language than the traditional language which employed by men in literature. So this is the second point, this is the second contribution of Ellen Showalter, a second model. This is the linguistic model. Next, students, we have women's writing and women's psyche. So this is psychological model. We can very simply state most essential and basic difference is the psyche. So very straightforwardly she is stating here that there is a basic difference and essential difference in the development of the psychology of women. And this psyche we found in traditional literature that women lack certain qualities, women do not have that mental strength, women are developed very differently than men. These kind of things we have in traditional literature or we have in the literature. So they think, generally men think, that women lack and hence they have disadvantages. There are many disadvantages, and these theories are basically based on Freudian and neo-Freudian analysis. And when we study Freud or psychoanalysis, we find that how Freud has given importance to the different types of psychological developments. He talks about conscious, unconscious and subconscious mind. And here we also have the same development in women. And we have here his major concern is about the Oedipus complex or Electra complex. What happens in Electra complex? We find that the girl is attracted more towards her father. So this is Electra complex. And next we again have two types of desires, erotic and egoistic desires. So these two types of desires are categorized accordingly the development of women's psychology. Erotic desires or dreams are always there hidden in the mind of women. And in the mind of men, we find egoistic desires or egoistic psyche. So this is the difference. Then we have a very special concept, that is psychodynamics of female bonding. So again, Elaine Showalter talks about this psychodynamics of female bonding. What is this psychodynamics of female bonding? She is talking about that how women is traditionally attributed different types of things in the society, and it is inherent made her to understand women from the point of view of women. And generally she is directly related to her mother. So boys are developed, or their psychology are being developed, as they are not male in negative sense. But in positive sense, we have women's psychologists developed, and she has given all the time the example of her mother. So these things, the qualities of mother is attributed to the qualities of her daughter. So this is the psychodynamic bonding. But here Elaine Showalter says that though this kind of things happened in the society, but this bonding is not the lack or the disadvantage of women or girl child, but this is the source of creativity. Through this source she can create many things, and hence here she is driving us from negative to the positive. So she thinks in a positive manner. So we have to take this psychodynamics of female bonding as a source of creativity. This is the third point she wanted to make here. Dear students, now we have last point, women's writing and culture. Now this is one of the comprehensive and complete model, and it is intermingled with other fields. So why this is comprehensive and complete model? Because we find there is agreement among many critics on this cultural model, because this cultural model is not related only to the field of culture, but the field of social aspects, we have political aspects, we have linguistic aspects, we have different types of nationalistic and many kinds of aspects related to this culture. So she is born and brought up in a particular culture, and hence she is we find that Simone de Beauvoir says that she is not born a woman, but she made a woman. One becomes a woman. So how it happens? It happens in the culture. And here we have Elaine Showalter's words, or here we have her quotation, who very straightforwardly states that how this model is comprehensive and complete. So the female psyche, I quote, "the female psyche can be studied as the product of or construction of cultural forces, a cultural theory acknowledges that there are important differences between women as writers. Class, race, nationality, and history are literary determinants as significant as gender. So, as gender is significant, in the same way, we have culture also significant, because it is a constructive force. It determines the development of women, it determines the psychology of women, it determines different aspects of the women. So, this is important in the model of culture. So, dear students, this is all about the four basic models propounded by Ellen Showalter. I hope you understood all these models, but if you feel any problem, any issue, you can directly comment. I will answer to your comment. So this is enough for this video. So please like this video, share this video among your friends, and subscribe to our channel Literature Simply, and also press the bell notification icon. Thank you very much. Let's meet in the next video.